Ever since the war broke out in Syria in 2011, several rounds of dialogues have been held, plans been outlined, and initiatives been proposed to end the conflict for good. Yet 6 years on, the war is still far from over. Most of the attempts to bring peace back to the Syrian people have so far fallen flat, mainly because the mediators often ignored the realities on the ground. Initial efforts mostly targeted the government of Syrian President Bashar Assad. Arab diplomats in early 2012 adopted a plan that would transfer Assad's power to a coalition cabinet. Damascus rejected it outright. The transition government issue was brought up again in June 2012 when global powers met in Geneva. The US wanted Assad out of the picture, Russia and China stood by Syrians' freedom of choice. The second Geneva conference also collapsed after two sessions of fruitless negotiations. The first breakthrough came only in November 2015 when the 23-member International Syria Support Group was formed in Vienna, Austria. Iran is now a partner in the peace process. A month later, a UN Security Council resolution endorses the process. In early 2016, and later during the next spring and summer, seven rounds of indirect negotiations were held between the government and foreign-backed opposition groups in the Swiss city, but all failed to produce any results. One of the reasons that Geneva Initiative never really took off was the emergence of another peace group in late 2016. Iran, Russia, and Turkey gradually took over the process, sidelining Americans. Seven rounds of talks have since been taking place and have led to the creation of four de-escalation zones in key areas of Syria. For the first time since the start of the war, signs of actual de-escalation appeared. The next stage will take place in the Russian resort of Sochi, where leaders of Iran, Russia, and Turkey are to meet on Wednesday to try to bring Syria one step closer to peace.